Winterberg in Germany in the Hoch Sauerland. We're close to the industrial heartland of the German Empire, and we are at one of the best known tracks in the business. This is where you bring your young drivers to learn how to slide. It is also the venue for race four of the BMW IBSF four-man bobsleigh World Cup. Good morning, everybody. Welcome wherever you are. Martin Haven and John Morgan getting ready for the action here. And John, this track is well known, but there are plenty of hazards that will just entice you into giving away your speed.
Yeah, it's, you know, built early, mid-70s, and Friedrich doesn't surprise anybody, their record. This is the zero curve, because they put this in, I think, in 2008, and this is curve one, and that zero curve causes a lot of problems for getting in the sled and getting around there smooth. Speeds are slow up here. You really can't make any kind of a mistake. It's flat right here. You almost go uphill. Now you got some action down here. This will set you up before this, these little two curves before the Kreisel. Another one of our Kreisels that we have, and you need to exit perfectly on the left side, right side, and curve nine. Well, this is where you can get in trouble. 9, 10, big sweeping right here. Now this three-quarter combination, this shows where the sleds are too fast for the track. They're airborne, and finish curve going uphill. You aren't finished yet. A lot of uphill. Martin, very short, easy track to get down. It's got a lot of Innsbruck personality in it. And the best thing about this track, the best thing about this track is there's a lot of Veltins around.
There is indeed the local sponsor, the local brewer. Well, let's take a look at how we are so far in our World Cup rankings. Francesco Friedrich with 3 wins from 3 starts, leads from Benny Meyer and Johannes Lochner. Last season, because of the odd way that it happened, we ended up with 12 two-man races and just 4 four-man races, the shortest season, I think, ever in World Cup history. This is now going to be race 4 of the season, and we will have race 5 here this weekend as well, because we're doing double four-man duty here in Winterberg. When we go to Sigulda in Latvia, well, this track is a bit on the small side for four-man. Sigulda is really on the small side for four-man. So Sigulda will be a double two-man weekend, and that way we even up the hit rate between two-man and four-man. We should have 8 of each as we get to the end of the World Cup season. And that, of course, will give everybody preparation for the games. Well, talking about the games, funnily enough, there are quite a few sleds here as a result of it being the Olympic season. We've got 26 on our start list. That is an awful lot of bodies packed into what is still a relatively small changing room. We start off with Germany's Christoph Hafer, former junior world champion. He will be first up. Last year's winner, Francesco Friedrich, goes off 6th. Justin Cripps took the silver medal last weekend. He's 13th. And about half the sleds here actually didn't race in last year's encounter. Race 4 of the BMW IBSF four-man bobsleigh World Cup. Martin Haven and John Morgan in Winterberg, Germany. Christoph Hafer gets the action underway. His 10th four-man World Cup start, and his best, a 6th place here in January.
Well, on his team is a guy named Matthias Sommer. He's one of 2 Sommers in the field. The other one, Ryan Sommer, slides for Canada. Sure, no relation, but Hafer knows the track well, Martin, and, you know, he doesn't get the starts the other German sleds get, but he is a very accomplished driver.
Well, the start is important here. You've got to carry the speed early into the Kreisel. Nice, smooth exit. Kreisel's quite early in the run here in Königssee, and in Altenburg, it's a lot further down the ice.
Martin, in the Innsbruck second event, he was disqualified, which is why he's way back. I didn't see why he was disqualified. Did you know?
No, he didn't crash, so I'm guessing it was a weight deal. 53.77 at the line.
8th last week in Altenburg. Slipped a little bit in the second run, but he's the rabbit. 53.77, Martin. Where's that towards our track record? Not bad.
Yeah, 53.48. Well, yesterday was a track record day. This is the fastest Winterberg ice ever, it is safe to say. Track record was broken in men's skeleton by the winner by a hundredth. In women's skeleton, though, they took the track record round the back and gave it a really thorough pasting. The fastest nine women in the first heat broke the track record. 10th place was a hundredth off. And it was broken again twice in the second heat. It ended up half a second lower than it was. Ivo de Brown next up, 41st four-man bobsleigh World Cup for him. And he's got a couple of 11th place finishes here. He'll need one of those again today to make one of the Olympic qualifications. Amber Hillenhaus reminds us that Christoph Hafer lost a brakeman, and that's why he didn't
That's right,
the run.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's right, 11, 18, and 22nd in three events. He's going to have to start to hustle. And, you know, he is in the Dutch Alps. This is favorite stomping grounds for the Netherlands. And they were stomping it up yesterday when they won the Women's World Cup skeleton event. She was impressive, Mark. You called the race. Track record and the final person down the track. That was very impressive.
Oh, huge skids. Trouble for Ivo de Brown. Really
Ooh,
needs to start
jump.
Hitting those
Ooh,
top eights, and he's almost gone. Wow.
How? Wow, is it just too fast? Wow.
Safe by the wall, but yeah, I mean, this is a very, very fast track. It certainly was yesterday, and today's sunny. I mean, those are track record conditions. Cold, hard ice, it was record fast yesterday. Big shine on it, sunshine, so there's no humidity, no frosting on the track. Yeah, a woo. Got away with that one. I don't know how. The replay will show us.
Tough getting these four mans in trouble, but when they get in trouble, they have a mind of their own. And Martin, this is where the sleds. Look how high he is there. Oh, got saved by that wall that they made higher. See the wall on the right? Wasn't that, you know, that wooden section wasn't there about 10 years ago.
Whoa. Yeah, that was a get-out-of-jail-free card, wasn't it? Next up, Italy's Mattia Variola. First World Cup start here as a driver. It's only his fourth World Cup race on the front. Did seven. He actually raced here as a brakeman for Simone Battazzo, who you'll see down at the bottom of the track helping collect the sled.
Didn't compete in the four-man race last week at Altenburg. He was on the start list. Martin just pulled out. You know, it was in the morning of. We got the notice would not compete.
Yeah.
Start, you know, not great. Second start, second velocity, decent. Thirteen hundredths back. That's relative to the start difference. You know, of 200s, got up to 13. That would have been some driving error there, too. Boy, he really skidded there. 2,500s, 30. He's got less speed than the Dutch.
Key for him here is going to be to try and make the cut into the top 20, get a second run, just to add to his knowledge of this track.
Yeah, watch out when you come through that little straightaway out of 9 to 10. It sets you up for here. This is much more in control of the sled compared to De Bruin, but he's still behind Ivo De Bruin by. So Ivo picks off one. He's going to have a reach to get it into the top 20.
Yeah. That might be Mattia Variola's only run here.
Learning, you know, former brakeman in the front seat. Carbonari, a lot of those Carbonaris in that. Sled right there. Watch this little skid here. Look at the back end. Doesn't seem like much. But here, looks like he steered a lot there to get off that curve, Martin.
Yeah.
You know, when you steer, and, you know, it wasn't perfect.
No, and first time here driving, so pretty inexperienced as well. Next up, Benny Meyer, less inexperienced, bronze medalist here, last time out. And he has two third place finishes here. Danut Moldovan back on the sled with Marcus Sammer and Christian Huber. I think that's Danut's first start of the season. Benny's 43rd World Cup race in four-man.
5.11, second in World Cup points with fifth a fourth, a fifth, and a second. Kristen Huber on the back of the sled, another one of those athletes that crossed over from decathlon. 600s, boy, that's, you know, Hoffer's time. He better not bleed any more time out of that 6 to 8. Yeah, he is, so he's not gonna match Hoffer down here either. Best
little
speed, though, Martin.
Yeah, Bunch little nudge away. Speed. Let's see what he's got lower down.
Not gonna do it, he got beat at the start. By 100, gonna get beat down here by over a 10. Pretty smooth ride, but
yeah,
this isn't the ride that the guy who's in second in World Cup points needed. Wolfgang Stomper, speed merchant in his own day. Just didn't have it going, Martin, and he all the way down the track.
Yeah.
1400s doesn't sound like much, but it is on this track. That looks like the Italian sled.
Yep.
And here comes Benny Meyer. This is the big 10 curve. Good aerodynamic profile from the athletes.
Miss you guys.
So we get next to our fifth of 23 starters. This is Oscars Kiebermannis, Dove Springs, Lauris Kaufmannis, Eggers Nimmer, the regular crew. Kiebermannis, 59th World Cup start, really with huge experience these days. Still only one win in Foreman, though.
Yeah, none of them are matching Hoffer's time, and Hoffer, because he has a middle of pack start time.
Well, at least everybody got in today. Yeah, that's a bonus. You can give away so much early on here, John. You know, you come uphill towards the camera there. It makes it look as though it's uphill. It literally is uphill. Until turn 5, you don't really start to go back downhill again, pretty much from the start.
Fourth best speed. He's, you know, he had one silver medal in Innsbruck, but 10th last week. He's one of those guys that's on that training regime that I'm going to peak in February, not in December.
There's a bronze medalist here in race one a couple of seasons back. That's not a bronze medal run today. Yeah, he'll make the cut. Not sure, 3/10 back. I don't think we're going to see a medal for him today.
Fifth, second, and 10th in 3 races. I would say he's on a 10th place spot now.
Just one medal out of this track in his career.
Well, the lines look pretty good there at 9. And then the big curve, look at the aerodynamics of the team sitting. Boy, the number 3 guy looks like he's really sitting up there.
You can hear the horn at the top as Christoph Hafer is our race leader. Stripping down, ready for action, Francesco Friedrich. 4 wins on this track, 4 silver medals and 1 bronze. Friedrich in his 68th four-man World Cup start. I'm gonna have to start looking back through his stats and see when or if he's missed World Cup races in a season. Not only is he fast, not only is he a good driver, but he stays healthy. He's insanely good, this guy.
Martin, the key is he's another decathlete. Those decathletes, they know how to deal with pain and pleasure and all of the above. And to get to that final event of the decathlon and have to run that mile. And that's what this bobsledding is. Ooh, mistake there. Bobsledding is, you know, it's a long season, long race. And by the time they get to the main prize, the Olympics or the World Championships, you're wounded. You got to put up with it. He's our leader.
By 700 of a second.
Not by much.
Christoph Hafer's run is looking very good, isn't it? Don't forget last week.
Wow, Hafer's got the lead. Is that the first heat of four-man bobsled that he's lost this year? Or was it last week?
Yeah, no, last week was 2-man. He came from 3rd. Was he leading in the first heat? I forget now. It's been a long week.
in four-man way back in China. He was first and first, and I know that he was in Innsbruck both races. I think this is the first time he's lost, and this is the reason here. Watch this. That little mishap right there on the way into Kreisel. Here. Boy, look how low the team is. The aerodynamics that they got in that sled with that team, and they're probably the four biggest guys, but not a smooth run for the dominating Francisco Friedrich.
No, leaves the door slightly ajar. Well, Maxim Andronov didn't race here last year. Last year, Alexei Stulnev was in the second Russian sled. Andronov, a fifth-place finisher back in 2018. That's his best result on this track. 35th four-man World Cup start with Alexei Zaitsev, Vasily Kondratenko, and Igor Gryatsnov on the back.
He's going to give up some time at the start. Ooh, 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 a lot of skid in there.
That's it, park it. All the speed, whatever they had at the start, just skid it away right there. If you get corner zero wrong, you have nothing left. Look at him, 3 tenths back before he gets to the uphill section of corner four.
Now he's going to have to be thinking about, you know, where he's going to finish here. I mean, he's got to be able to get ahead of the Italians at the bottom, but he's going to be behind De Bruyne at this pace.
Well, you say Goda, I mean, he was rough out of six. He didn't exactly look comfortable.
He's going to be falling behind the Italians. His pace.
He's skidding here.
Going to be about 6,500, maybe 7. He's going to be last.
Yeah.
With that mistake.
He's going to be last.
77. Wow. I know. I'd shake my hand, too. A guy with this much experience, Martin.
Comes back to corner
seven.
Zero.
He's
seventh now, but there's another 18 sleds to come, or 16 sleds to come. If we see the going away shot at the start, as they load, the sled breaks loose, and that's it. Then it's done. They need an off-ramp.
Oh, look at that. Yeah. They ran too far.
Or he didn't have his hands on the D-rings, but you need an off-ramp here, because if you make a mess of corner zero, just park it. That's it, forget it, let's go home. Yeah.
And remember, it's curve zero. Wasn't there when I arrived in this track in the 70s, I hate to say, but they put it in 2008.
None of the buildings were here when you arrived at this track.
It was pretty wide open.
So let's see what Rostislav Gajtukovic can produce. Bronze medal in four-man for the first time in his career. Last week in Altenburg, they load cleanly, 5.07. Gets a decent little bump in corner zero.
Yeah, the good speed, but the third best velocity, second best start at 07. The only 100 back of Friedrich at the start. That's pretty impressive for the young Russian who won a medal last week in four-man bobsled, won a medal in two-man bobsled, Martin, and he seems to me to be the athlete that's making the biggest jump up the leaderboard this season.
Well, you know, we kind of looked at him last year and went, oh boy, he's coming, isn't he? He's definitely arrived this year with a bullet. 1,100s back. This is battling to stay ahead of last year's bronze medalist. But
not going to do it. It's going to be fourth.
No. Fourth at the line behind Benny Meyer and ahead of Oscar Kibermanis. Well, look, we saw yesterday the track was quicker than anybody has ever slid it. And of course, you say that rather glibly, but it means these sleds today are getting into the turns quicker than any of these drivers have ever done before.
Well, I don't know. They're still 3 tenths off the track record. That was the second,
they're quicker than they were in training, that's for sure.
Oh, for sure. Look how high he is here. And he has to Robin Hood it off. But that'll do that. I mean, these curves are the same as they were in the 70s down here. The sleds and the athletes are a little faster. The bottom part of the track.
Yeah. Next up, Hunter Church of the USA, Josh Williamson, Chris Horn, and Charles Volker on the back. This is Hunter's 15th four-man World Cup start, and he's actually had two of those here already. Two eighth-place finishes in his two previous appearances, so this is clearly a track that he has done well at.
going to be the start. This is Vogler's first start here ever on this track. He's a rookie on tour, the football player from Princeton. Nice load.
Nice
great
load.
Great start.
507.
Great velocity. Well, you know, they got that push track over there, and the U.S. team has had some great heats. They haven't had two heats together. It's been their problem.
400 up. That
skid, that should bring it back to neutral.
Little skid there as well, out of five. What about the Kreisel?
Speed has dropped off a little bit, but still looks like a top five.
Yeah. Those skids will hit your speed. From zero down to five, you don't accelerate at all.
Really good out of nine. See, oh. Really good.
He's almost at the bottom, isn't it?
But he's, you know, good speed, but he's still almost, almost like too much steering. Fifth is a good run.
Wow, yeah, second, and only 100th speed behind Guy Tukovic. That's a good run, isn't it?
Yeah. Looked like the thing was up. Too much control. That was a good run right down the middle of the track. Hunter, third generation bobsledder. That wasn't perfect in curve one, but they had the best velocity. Here, a little late there. That causes a little bit of trepidation on the back, a little touch.
Light to fly, baby!
That was the edited for clean broadcast version. Brad Hall next up, 35th World Cup start for him, or actually the 34th he will start, because here last year they just ran out of bodies that weren't broken and had to pull out on race morning. January 2020, he finished ninth here. Let's see what they've got. They've had a good season so far. 5.07 is the benchmark, isn't it?
Yeah, a little hard tap, though, out of curve one. The velocity wasn't that great. But Brad, he's got it going this year. He had a second in Innsbruck and then fell off with an 11th, and last week, ninth. But a Martin, again, he's come out of the blocks pretty good this year.
Yeah. First weekend in Innsbruck was a charm. He got bronze in the two-man, silver in the four-man. First, we believe, first weekend where a British sled has gained medals in both categories in any World Cup weekend.
Well, I'm sure there's somebody watching who could tell us if that's correct.
I'm not sure there is. I don't think they have a John Morgan back home in BBSA. 54.07. And that is that's 200s behind Hunter Church, 300 behind Rostislav Gajtukovic.
It's a tie.
And it is a dead heat. Yeah, Oscar
Kiebermatis.
I knew the 07 sounded familiar. I'm starting to get Rain Man fatigue now.
Yeah, so we got four sleds separated by 300s for the second run so far.
So far is right, yeah.
And this is a pretty good exit here into the 10. Aerodynamics, the number two guy's up too high. They got to get two and three got to get down. All they got to do is look at what Friedrich's team does. Of course, they might have had a little bit more time in the wind tunnel than the Great Britain team.
That is true enough. So we have our first 10 sleds down. Christoph Harfer is the leader by 100th from Francesco Friedrich. Well, a three-time winner in second place at the moment, a three-time winner on the line. Hansi Lochner's got three four-man wins on this track. He was only fifth in the last race, in January this year. And that is his worst ever result here, 5.05.
But they only had the fourth best velocity, Martin.
That's because they were tapping around out of the zero curve.
Yep.
Well, he's got his regular crew behind him, but two of his other brake men were in Christoph Harfer's crew.
Yeah. 700's up. Second best speed.
Hansi's 40th World Cup race. Is he going to add a 10th victory to the 9 gold medals he's had so far? 800's up.
Seventh and fourth, the last two events, second at the opening event, so he's putting himself, he will be the leader. It'll be a 1-2-3 German field
here. The fourth best speed, but 100. It's 300, three sleds covered by 200s. Fantastic, that's what we want to see. Nobody's going to win this one going away. Well, maybe not in the first heat, but they lead.
This smells like a German sweep to me. They're all going to have those big glasses of Veltins at the bottom.
All right, stop salivating.
Well, the start, okay, they had the best start time, but what happened to the speed? Watch the sled here.
What's happening? Well,
looks
Hansi,
like the guy on the right kind of ran too far.
Hansi submerges into the seat as he gets in. Now they're running out of drive lines right here.
Well, he's done well with, he's got his hands on the D-rings, but they're still not settled coming around that curve. Comes in late. Oh, you saw the steer. There's the bang. And then he bangs again. No, so that skidding there cost him the speed velocity.
Yeah, otherwise, well, that could be a 10th ahead. Next up, Michael Vogt of Switzerland, 21st World Cup start for him. Had his best ever four-man result in Altenburg last week with a top six finish.
Yeah, he's sentenced to six best start, eight best velocity. So he's hoping he can get to within that five, six, seven, the tie for seven with 30 hundredths back. 16 hundredths back now. If he'll be fast on the bottom, Martin. Turning into a pretty accomplished pilot, He just came out this quad.
And we're looking at top eight, top 12 for the Swiss Federations and for their National Olympic Association. National Olympic Association wants three top 12 results. Swiss sliding wants three top eights to qualify.
He's on the verge of getting beat by Ivo de Bruyn, though.
Well, it's drifting away from him.
Could be 11th.
He could be 11th. He's
10th. So Ivo de Bruyn picks off someone else, so he's closer to being in the mix.
Well, critically, Ivo's got three sleds behind him, so any question of whether or not he makes the cut is now completely gone. He will absolutely be in the second heat. 26 sleds, I beg your pardon. I was thinking 23.
Three more he's got to pick off.
No, you're right.
Here, the drive down the track. Not bad, a little late there, but, a little late, really got on that nine loose. And then down here, look at the runners. Does he steer off? No, but the back end did a pretty good skid here. Watch the sled skid, bang, a little airborne. Then you start going uphill to the finish.
I tell you what, the way they have cut 12-13 this year, it's very wild in everything. Next up, Justin Cripps, silver medalist in this race last year. This is his 94th four-man race, 71 of those as a driver now. 5.06, but loses the velocity.
Yeah, six best at the start with the speed. Give me a choice of the start time or the velocity. I'll take the velocity every time. And Cripps, as you said, silver medal in this event last year, but at the moment he's hanging in there, doing very well. Second best speed. This is someone else going to challenge the Germans for that Veltins beer drinking at the bottom.
Yeah.
10 hundredths back. He's falling there. Looks like fourth. He's him and Benny Meyer on a collision course here.
Yeah. Benny's 15 well, they were hundredths second back. And third. Second and third last year, weren't they? Cripps ahead of Meyer. Yeah.
So 15 hundredths is Meyer. 13 hundredths is 200 ahead of Benny Meyer.
In it.
For the second Ryan, the second summer athlete of the day, Ryan Summer comes down, and the Summers are in first and fifth, first and fourth.
They've got the podium surrounded.
Second and fourth, excuse me. Here's up in nine. Watch the crossover here. Look, tap.
Yeah, and then you get that back
Not
bunk.
Not bad. Hits. I think he had to steer through there. Let's bust him on the aerodynamics. Looks very good. You don't even see two. So, pretty good.
Yeah, you look at that shot and you say, is everybody in the sled?
Yeah.
Dominik Dvorak for the Czech Republic. Another brakeman turn driver. 32nd race as a driver. His 43rd four-man in total. Jan Sindelar, Jakim Prochazka, the new boy, and Jakub Nošek are the crew again. finished in ninth place here in the last race, but he's got 3 7th place finishes on this track.
Yeah, hasn't had some great results, 12th, 13th, and 12th. Used to get better start times, Martin. He doesn't get the starts he used to get.
Seems to have slipped a bit since last season. Let's see if he's in the zeros now. 5:14. Yeah.
So now he's sentenced to 12th or 13th to finish that. This decathlete from Prague was a sports instructor. Used to be a good brakeman, and Martin would talk about his prowess. He might be one of the fastest guys in the front seat of all the drivers.
Nice smooth lines early on, but 3 tenths back, that lack of speed at the start is still haunting him.
Good lines. 4 tenths back, looks like I thought about 11th or 12th.
Oh!
You gotta pay the penalty there.
Yeah.
See if he's late here. No, he gets through the, no problem. Boy, perfect. I mean, very pedestrian ride there, but sometimes the pedestrian rides are slow. And that one was 12th place. Ivo De Bruin has picked off the Swiss, the Czechs, the Italians, and the Russians. Ivo's in the race. I will now say Ivo De Bruin is in the race. He could be like 14th to 15th at this pace, Martin.
Yeah.
Okay, the critique into 9. Good profile from the athletes. And now watch this little mistake. He gets over a little late there, causes him to come cross over here. Look him over to the right. That pushes him into the middle of the curve. You push into that big curve 10. You got to steer hard. You steer down there in that part of the track. It's like putting the brakes on.
Cody Baskew for the USA, 40th four-man World Cup race for Cody. Carlo Valdez, Jimmy Reed, and Hakim Abdul-Sabur. 3 World Cups here for Cody, 2 in 2017, 1 in the spring, 1 in the fall, and then nothing until January 21. So a 4-year hiatus from racing in Winterberg. He's having to relearn it.
Uh-oh, late. Look behind him. 5. Ooh, tap there, 9th best speed. Yeah. Trouble, 7th best start, 9th best speed, but the number 2 guy had some problems getting in there. Cody now has to drive the perfect line. He's only 1,200s back there. That's not bad. He should have been more back with that efficiency. Yeah.
Well, that 10th came from that problem in corner 0. It'll be 2 tenths, it'll be 3 tenths almost by corner 9.
Yeah, he'll be struggling now to get the top 10.
That speed lost early on, it's almost impossible to get it back. These big sleds are too hard to get down clean.
Real. Boy, he steered hard there perfectly. Whoa. Almost.
12th best speed. Could be a top 10 run for Cody Baskew. No, slips to 12th place behind Mikhail Vogt, but ahead of Dominic Dvorak. Now, the question is, how well is the track going to hold up in the sunny weather?
Yeah, you're right.
We don't have too many more benchmarks, you know.
We got spring.
Of the next half dozen, there are half dozen crews who could go really well, but could also be a bit off par, and it's hard to tell. Some of the mistakes there.
Yeah, this is, boy, steered out of here perfectly, which leads me to believe right here. Look at how, this is really good lines, but maybe too much steering, Martin.
Little skid from 11 into 12, but these things just won't go straight on this track. I mean, a long way up the outrun. Luckily, not concrete. It's been well frosted up. Hatzi Lochner leads, 15 sleds down. Next up is our second Swiss driver, Simon Friedli. Dominic Schlepfer, Greg Jones, who made his first World Cup start last weekend. Back in the sled, and Andreas Haas. Haas was subbed out of the two-man in Altenburg on race morning. Hopefully he is feeling a bit fitter.
Last week in Altenburg. Best finish of the 3 events. The Swiss in and down. The 14th best start, but the 9th best velocity. So the team does well with the entry to the sled. And now Well, you talked about having some good eyes and hands. This is where you really have to have them up top of this track where there's no steering allowed. I mean, it's almost meticulous body movement sometimes to get out and off some of these curves at speeds that are so slow.
It's a little bit like the early corners in St. Moritz. There's no speed, there's no pressure. You can skid so easily and just destroy your run.
It's a good line.
The skids are more dramatic, but less damaging in terms of pace. Only 14th best speed, though. So he's going to be 13th, 14th at the line. Yeah, 100th behind Dominic Dvorak.
Ivo de Bruyne had a bad run, and he's 10th. And he doesn't he have to get a 7th place to qualify?
8th. The Dutch always go 8th. I'm assuming that's because you can only have 8 people in a speed skating race. So basically, you qualify if you make the start.
That replay up top, skid into 8, set up into 9. And a little late, you saw the heads slap right to left, and watch the heads here.
Whoa, yeah.
And when you see the articulation split like that, and then the bang, the sled goes a little bit airborne, not bad.
And the cloud of ice that follows as well, that's all creating a lack of energy in the sled. So 16 sleds down in our field of 26. 10 sleds remain, only 4 spots in the race. I'm saying right now, Maxim Antonov of Russia is not getting a second run. What about Mihai Tenteya? Capable of a top 10 run, I think pretty much on any track we go to these days. Raul Dobrik, Ciprian Dorocci, and Christian Radu in neatly, but a little tap out of 0.
Yeah. 14th start, 14th velocity. You know, he's pretty good on the tougher tracks, Martin. We're having a lot of respect for his driving. 16th, 15th, and 15th for 2-3 events in the season.
And he normally ends up out-driving his start by 3 or 4 positions. If he starts 18th, he'll normally end up sort of 14th, 15th. Where are we now?
He's sentenced to 15th.
Yeah.
14th to 15th now. But he does a little bit better than the two men. Yeah. You know, everything they're doing well.
Line. Got to be ahead of Anjanov and Variola to try and make this race. And the Romanian across the line in 16th, so behind Mattia Variola by 700ths of a second. Again, the first 2 or 3 sleds that went early, that fresh spritz on the ice, the real hard, fast ice, looks like they've handled it quite well, and they're taking the benefit.
I don't think he's making the field.
I think it's going to be a tough call. You're right.
I think he's going to be right in the bubble, 20th.
Yeah.
Here, it's trying to snake through 9 to 10. That was very clean. Here, look at the articulation. Look at the back end come up there. Articulation split pretty hard, as it does almost with every sled. And there's our little cloud of exhaust.
And, of course, that's just carving up the track as well, and it's doing it everywhere else. We just don't see so much of it. Next up, Chris Spring with Mike Evelyn, Cody Sorensen, and Sam Giguere. Cody asking the question, actually, on social media. I was away from bobsled for 8 years and came back. Is that a record? That's got to be a record. You know, it's one thing to go away and come back as a coach, but to come back as an athlete, that's amazing.
Yeah, he's got some suspect starts. He's going to have all he can do to get in the top 15. Good finish last week, 11th in Altenburg on a track that Springer's got some history with. He did great in the two-man event, though, close to the top 4.
Well, he's driving pretty much as well as he's ever done, Chris Spring, I reckon, this season, which is exactly what you want in an Olympic year. Could be a top 10 run right now. Look at the speed.
13th to 11th. And maybe the 10th here if he keeps it online. 31, 11th best speed. He's in 10th at the moment. He's got great line there into the big 10 curve. Watch the three-corner combination down here. And very nice. 17th best speed, though.
Lost a little out of 13.
12,
but
he lost
the line
on the bottom.
Yeah. But listen, see, going off 18th, and what was it, a 13th best start? He ends up 12th. I'm saying he made very good use of the ice there.
Something happened, though, because he was 10th at the bottom, Martin. and went from 10th to 12th in the last split. Let's watch it. This is where you would make the mistake, the crossover at the exit of 9. There.
The way the sled rolls up there.
There.
That's 10. Here's an 11.
This is it. The aerodynamics look great, and the Canadian four guys are perfectly set in there, especially two. Couldn't tell where he lost it, but the Springer lost a 10th down there in the bottom.
Well, next up, Frenchman Roman Heinrich, one of the few in this end of the field that was actually in the race last year, finished in 8th place. Lionel Lefebvre, Thomas Delmest, and Jerome Laparelle, the great team. Same as last week.
Well, gonna need a start. Can't make any kind of mistake here at all. 13th best start,
and 18th best
velocity.
In zero.
Yeah, so now he's sent to the back of the field, and I say he's going to make the cut, Martin, but he's 16th in points, 22nd, 9, and 17 in three races. So he hasn't got this big sport utility sled online the way he wants it yet. Late there on two runners. 19th best velocity, Martin. This is on the bubble.
Yep. This is going to be a struggle, I'm afraid. 18th, he's just losing speed, and it all comes from that corner zero. You might as well jog off if you're going to get corner zero wrong. 72 hundredths back. This is going to be the slowest run of the day. He is not making the second heat either. That's his day done, surely. I can't believe that only one sled of the remaining seven are going to be slower than that.
The track could be really deteriorating.
Yeah, that definitely isn't helping, but you go back and watch corner zero.
This is it. This is why he's in 19th. Watch the sled in, down. Number three guy looks like he ran too far, and then look at this. Watch the...
Too much to the left.
Yeah, and he hits that. Look at that. And that bang, that just erases all your velocity that you just tried to achieve.
And from the same, from the exact same start, Chris Spring came down 34 hundredths quicker.
Yeah.
But so much is lost before corner four, you never, ever get it back. 20th of our 26 starters, Li Chunjian of China, Ye Ji Long behind him, Shi Hao and Chen Heng on the back.
They weren't in the race last week, Martin. They got some issues. Not a bad start, though, 13th, but 17th best velocity. They didn't compete in the four-man last week.
Well, a few sleds came here for Europa Cup to help them learn the track, and I didn't look at the results. Didn't have time to get to that, but I think Lee may have been here last week as well.
Yeah, he wasn't. This is the first time we've seen him in a four-man race.
It's another 5:14 start. So the same as Chris Spring and Roman Heinrich, but this is not as quick as Heinrich's. Just about as
little
as Heinrich.
He's probably going to get Heinrich right here.
He's dropped away behind the French sled.
84 hundredths, 81. He's 84 hundredths is Heinrich, so he could be 19th or 20th.
Yeah.
99, 20th. Pierre, what do you think, Pierre? I think the track's gone, Mark. I really do.
I think the track has. The other fact with the Chinese athletes, of course, is they didn't slide any tracks outside China last year. This year, it really doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter if they're not performing here. I mean, apart from morale, you know, the points don't count. They will have their own selection process. Pierre and the association will choose the athletes. And, of course, they know the Beijing track, and that's going to be their key weapon in their arsenal.
Let's look at the aerodynamics. Looks like number three is up way too high. Yeah, so they'll correct that.
Yeah, put some lead in his helmet. Weigh his head down. Hansi Lochner, Christoph Hafer, Francesco Friedrich, the tight top three covered by 200s. 20 sleds down, 6 to go. First 20 sleds completed their runs. Race 4 of the BMW IBSF four-man bobsleigh World Cup here in Winterberg, Germany. Marcus Treichel, 21st starter, trying to make it into the top 20. Good getaway, John Morgan. That gives him a shot.
Well, 19th best start, but the 14th best velocity, so his team has been well drilled on getting in the sled. And of course, getting in the sled and getting around that zero curve. I don't know who thought about putting that curve in there 13 years of skid there. 13 years ago when they did that, but boy, was that a good idea.
It was that whole new start facility with the upstairs, the underground, and everything. Yeah. It just didn't join the track, so they had to adapt the track.
He's in the field, Martin. Going to be 17th or 18th, but he's got to watch out. He can't fall asleep down here. One more
like
curve.
A top 15 run early on. And it's rocking 17. Away. Only 19th at the line. Will he be 18th? 17th. Okay.
He's in the field.
Well,
right ahead, Tentea.
Yeah. Li of China is out.
Out. Heinrich is on the
bubble. 20th. Anjanov in 19th. Again, I think neither of them are likely.
Two more sleds that I think that can challenge here. Juan Baumgartner. I don't know about Dean. I don't know about him, but skid there, Martin, up top. 8. And then the crossover here, a little late. Friction. And saw those heads. And then down here in the. This is down into 10. Skidding. Saw the articulation split a little bit. Big sport utility, that vehicle.
Well, next up, a man who has possibly seen his, or is running through his final World Cup season, Yun Jung-won of Korea, the Olympic silver medalist. That will be a day that he will be able to tell his grandchildren about proudly for many, many years. But what about today? Is he going to make the cut here?
Start time. Going to have to get a 15th best start. 21st best start. 9th best velocity, so we'll give him some benefit of the doubt. And yes, Martin, what a legendary silver medal that he posted on behalf of his nation, Korea, but also for Asia, the first Asian athlete ever to win a medal in Olympic medal in bobsledding. And people forget he was the two-man overall World Cup season winner in 15-16. Everybody expected him to challenge for a medal in two-man, but in four-man, he pulled it off.
Yeah. And it's not an easy business. Where is he going to end up, though? Will he be in the race right now?
Barely.
He is only the 21st start. And this is him or Roman Heinrich. And Heinrich is out, and Juan is on the bubble. Wow.
Andrianov
only Heinrich
is
by 300. Andrianov is breathing again.
Yeah, I think Andrianov's in. I think he's in. Andrianov.
Him and his crew have been up the top for half an hour, shining runners and prepping the sled. I don't know.
Look at the aerodynamics here of his crew. Number 3 may be a little high. 2 is great. Yeah, 3's up too high. A lot of bouncing around back there, Martin.
Yeah. He's 300s behind Andrianov. Andrianov 100th behind Mihai Tentea. But we still have 4 sleds to go. Patrick Baumgartner could make it here. Oh, hello. It's another non-Italian sled. So they have a rented 4-man. Now, I wonder whose sled this was. Let's see if we can take a look. Is this a Valner? Is this a Hansi Lochner? Or
it's got DHL on it, so it's probably German.
It is a German sled. Just trying to figure out. I'm sure it can't be an FES.
Who skid? 21st best start, 15th best speed. They did pretty good. Baumgartner did pretty good last weekend.
Yes, he did.
14th in the 4-man on a very difficult track. And he's going to have to show some. This former Alpine skier is going to have to find some kind of quick line here, because he's going to be right on the bubble, which is he is right now.
Look at the speed, 20. Though. Yeah, this is a Valner sled, but from one of the German drivers. Now, I don't know who, might be from Hans-Peter Hannikott, could be from anybody, frankly, but This is him in the race.
Oh, no, or he's not going to do it.
No. Up to the Chrysler he was in, and he is out. Okay, 54-65 ahead of Li of China and behind Roman Heinrich. So Yun Zhongwon hangs on. I think potentially one of the remaining three sleds might do it, but coming this late on a sunny morning might be
he could have been
a hill too far.
Hoffer, the German, drew number one. He's in fourth place,
yeah.
Right?
Off what,
no, he's
off
in what, second third, place.
Second place, rather. Off what looked like a decent, but not a brilliant run.
Number one starter. He had big eye. You give Bumgardner the number one start. He's in the field probably like 13th or 14th place. So luck of the draw. The first three athletes get drawn randomly. The athletes in the back of the pack, and it was a good draw for Hoffer.
Yeah, it sure was. Well, what about Dubs Kafmanis? A Latvian with precious little experience. And he made his first four-man World Cup start last week in Altenburg.
Yeah, no, he had 16th the week before in Innsbruck.
I beg your pardon, in Innsbruck, yeah. So let's see.
13th best start, 15th best velocity. Now, let's see what Mr. Kafmanis has. Boy, you see some shoulders back there.
The best place driver off a 5:14 start is Chris Spring in 12th, but I'm afraid Davis is going in the opposite direction. 13th at the start, down to 17th on the splits, 20th best speed.
18th.
There's not much left in the ice, is there, John?
No, but he's going right to the number. Good,
yeah.
With a good exit here. Watch out.
Oh, and he's gone.
So yeah, I saw that.
It's not going to be quicker than one.
Could see it on 10. Saw it on 10.
Well, tough break for those guys, but man,
he was in the field.
Just dodged a bullet. Yeah, he was kicking one out.
Yeah, he was in the field. He got too late on 10. I yelled, "Watch out!" because he was too late. Came over when he hit 11, pushed him to the middle. I knew he was going to be late on 12, 13. Too bad. He was in the field, Martin.
Yes,
he would have knocked out one.
Not by much, but he was going to make it. Yeah. Well, the guys are all out of the sled in one piece, and that's the critical factor, unfortunately. Although they do get a time. Well, here we are. This is 11.
Watch him late. Now watch him climb. Here in the end, climbs up, gets out of here late, and then crosses over and taps the take out of the next curve. He's late there. Right here, look how late he is here. Look up near the wood. Hits the take. Oh, no, that was the setup.
Yeah, that's 13.
Before this is where his mistake was. Not the way you want to look at the next curve.
Oh.
So now they got to check the track out. And the last person I saw do this was Jim Herbrick, write himself up in the finish curve. It must have been the 96 season, 97 season.
Gutted. Absolutely gutted. The drivers feel so much responsibility for their brakemen, you know, literally their health and well-being is in the driver's hands. There's going to be a break now before Lamindine, which is probably the last thing he needed, as the track workers just examine to make sure there are no gouges. So Lamindine's crew and Ryo Shinohara of Japan, the last two sleds to go. Trying to keep warm. They've warmed themselves up. They've got themselves psyched up and ready to go. Now you've just got to put that all on hold for an undisclosed time. It may well be a five-minute track hold just to make sure there are no gouges. They're going quick down the bottom there, John. 135 kilometers an hour nearly, which is, 138 actually. That's getting
78.
80,
so almost 80 miles an hour.
85 miles an hour, yeah.
Martin, I bet you in my day I was going through there, I bet you about 115, 110 kilometers an hour. That's how much it's changed. The sleds, the tracks are the same, except for curve zero on this track, but everything else is pretty much the same. Although the finish curve was totally different Martin, when I was here, the finish curve went the other way, and way back. And they made that change, I would say, in the 90s. But they made that curve zero change, I think, about 2008.
86 miles an hour is the top speed at the bottom, 85.997. Accurately, but 86 miles an hour. Quite quick enough when you're the right way up. Feels probably a lot quicker when you're not.
There's the labyrinth. There's the three-quarter combination at the bottom part of the track that, you know, they talk about those old tracks in NASCAR, you know, and Darlington and Martinsville. And, you know, the cars are a lot faster.
Well, even the new tracks aren't that new anymore, are they? Places like Texas, Las Vegas, they've been around 20 years now, and as you say, technology doesn't slow down any. Getting ready to go then. Two sleds remain. Lamin Dean, Toby Alubi, Joel Fearon, and Ben Simons for Great Britain. And Lamin has never missed the cut in a four-man race on this track. Best result, seventh place, 2015. He was eighth in 2019. This is a big pressure run. Needs to make the cut here. The delay won't help the frame of mind, but he's been around the block a couple of times.
It's not his first rodeo.
No, it sure ain't.
So he's got to get into a start time of 5, 11, or 12. They've got to get some good velocity.
Ooh, skids.
That's not good. 5.14. Velocity.
19.
Very suspect. 23rd best velocity. So
well,
that's going to be.
Skid doesn't help them.
He's going to have to find a shortcut because he's not in the mix. And number three guy, is that Toby with the white helmet? Toby's up.
No, Toby's at two, I think, right behind Lamin, so.
It's Joel. Number three, guys. Too much white helmet.
24th place, 17th best speed. He really needs to be clean below the Kreisel here. Out of 11. Not making up enough ground. Just not sure there's much speed left in the track. 20th at the bottom and 23rd at the line.
And he, Peter,
for the first time, does not make the cut.
The sentence to the back of the field with the draw. You know, the guy that comes out of here, they draw three sleds from the back of the field to go in the first three. And that was Haffer, De Bruin, Variola. Those three guys had the big opportunity. Look at this. See that skidding?
Yeah.
Look at the skidder. Look at him. He squares. He squares around the first curve. Actually, that wasn't bad.
That's not too bad. Yeah, I thought it was going to break into a big skid and a big slap, but there's just, yeah. I mean, if it hadn't been sunny as well, the track would still have more pace in it, but it's ifs, buts, and whatevers. Unfortunately, for the first time in 9 World Cup starts, Lamin Dean does not make the cut. Our final sled in, Ryo Shinohara, a Japanese with Tatsuya Hamano, Yoshiki Kaneko, and Kenji Murakami behind him. Well, this is the crew. Kaneko and Murakami have both had two-man starts this season with Shinohara.
He's 26th best velocity and start, and most likely 26th at the bottom.
Yeah.
Well, he could still beat Gothmanis, who had a mishap there in the finish area. Yeah, you could see the 2, 3, and 4 guys, the helmets. You see too much of the helmets.
Six all the way down. Yeah. Again, about experience and about seeing whether or not we're going to get a Japanese sled in the games. Ooh. 25th speed at the bottom, but that rocky exit out of 13 will definitely have given the crew a bit of a Code Brown moment. 55-35 at the line. Yep. Davis Kaufmanis, despite that corner 14 crash actually recorded a slightly quicker time than Ryo Shinohara. Shinohara got quite close to rolling there, didn't he?
Well, you have to be cohesive. Look at the number three guy, still trying to get in. The brakeman's waiting patiently. Number two guy still not in, and this, they should be down before this. Number two guy's waiting for the three. Then the brakeman falls in place. The arm smoke, the brakeman's turn. Look at the brakeman struggle to get in there, too. So the cohesion needed to load a four-man bobsled, that wasn't how to do it. And down here, Martin, boy, he was close.
Yeah. Whoa. And the whip as all of the bodies get thrown back the other way. You know, all of that is energy coming out of the sled that should be helping it go forward. So, yeah, those rough transitions, it's not just the skids and the hits. It's where all the energy is getting thrown around inside. Should be driving the sled forward. Well, Johannes Lochner is our race leader after the first of two heats. Don't forget, it is a double four-man weekend. So if you have a big day today, you're coming back loaded for bear tomorrow.
It'd be pretty tough to unseat a German here. I mean, any one of the Germans out of the top three. Hoffer, though, did have a big advantage. He went early. Cripps went 13th, so don't count Cripps out of a medal yet.
Hoffer is the potential to fall out of this, but three sleds covered by 200 should be a great battle. Cripps and Meyer, silver and bronze last time out here. Nitukovic fresh off a bronze medal last time out. He is the best of the rest. And then Hunter Church, Brad Hall, 7th and 8th. They had good runs. Evo de Brown ended up in 10th. So that early draw certainly didn't hurt him. It was not the cleanest of runs. He's ahead of Vogt and Spring and Bascu and the rest. And down at the tail of the field, Maxim Anjanov. I said early on he wasn't going to get a run. So there he is in the field ahead of Yun Jungwon. But Heinrich Baumgartner, Dean Lee, Kaufmannis and Shinohara will have to watch the second heat from the trackside. You can join them and us. We will be back at 11:30 local, 10:30 GMT, 05:30 Eastern. Till then, on behalf of the IBSF TV crew, for John Morgan, I'm Martin Haven, saying thank you for joining us. We'll see you for the second and deciding heat.